because of what Colleen Herman is calling an unprovoked attack.
On quiet summer afternoons like today, the mood at the Banks Dora District is breezy and calm. But around 1 a.m. on Saturday, July 3rd, Colleen Herman says chaos prevailed and shared these photos online to support her view. In this Facebook post, Herman said she and her husband, David, quote, were assaulted by a group of what we heard was about 10 men and a female at the Banks after the Reds game. We were waiting for an Uber when we were attacked from behind and beaten brutally. It was outside of Jefferson Social. The attack was completely unprovoked. We had not had any words with them or ever even seen them before, end quote.
I'm actually shocked because I go to the Banks all the time.
I showed Herman's social media post to Nastasia Williams and her friends a few blocks away from the entertainment zone that's nestled between the stadiums where the Reds and Bengals play. The area's Dora designation means people are allowed to walk with drinks outside.
Like, it shouldn't be happening down there. That's a common area where we all like to go, so we would like to be able to, even at 1 a.m, we still want to be safe.
Police have arrested 19-year-old Faith Parker. She's accused of being highly intoxicated while fighting. More arrests are possible as investigators review body camera footage and relevant security camera video. Ayanna Pouncey wonders what would compel such violence in a place crowded with people during the late night hours.
It could be coming from a lot of things, and there's just nothing for kids to get into.
And so the worry is they get together at the Banks.
And then they get into the wrong things or whatever. It could be at the wrong place at the wrong time, and, you know, and it just doesn't end well.
Now, I've requested interviews with police on multiple occasions to find out the latest about the investigation so far, and no police official has been willing to get in front of a camera to talk about it. I also went to the home that Faith Parker, that suspect, now recent court filings indicate she's 18, went to the home that she gave investigators after her arrest. No one was there at the time. For now, reporting live at the Banks, Todd Dykes, WLWT News 5.
Now, Todd, we understand David Herman ended up at the hospital. What more can you tell us about that?
Yeah, actually, you know, that Facebook post we've been referencing said that David Herman was being monitored for possible brain bleeding. I've talked to Colleen Herman, his wife, on the phone, and I reached out to her again this morning to see if she had any comment about the situation today. I've not heard back, certainly hoping that he's okay. Ashley?
All right, Todd, live for us down at the...